A warm morning to my dear children. Welcome to class 2, subject EVS. Today, your ma'am is here to teach you a new lesson, chapter 15, The Plant Kingdom. So children, all of you give attention here. See this page, children. See this page, name the parts of a plant by using the egg box. You can write the names of the plants. Okay, children. So, the first one, bud. Bud, it changes into a flower. Second, root. They hold the plant firmly in the soil. Okay, children. Third, flower. They changes into fruits. That is cleared. Now, leaves. Leaves are mostly green in color. They prepare food for the old plants. Okay. Next is fruit. They have seeds inside them. They see the seeds, children. They have seeds inside them. Okay. So, seeds grow into a plant. Okay. Next, stem. They make the plant stand straight. They hold the plant to stand straight, or they make the plants stand straight, stem. So that is clear, children. Now we can learn about plants. Plants. We see plants all around us. The world is full of beautiful plants around us, isn't it, children? So, we all like to see beautiful plants in our garden. Okay. So, they are of different shapes, sizes and colors. Then children, like humans, animals and plants too have life in them. So, plants do not move, but they grow. So, children, we see plants all around us. The world is full of beautiful plants. And we like to see the beautiful plants in our garden too. Okay, children? So that is clear. Now, how do plants prepare their food? Green plants prepare their food with the help of sunlight, air and water. How do plants prepare their food, children? Green plants prepare their food with the help of sunlight, air and water. Okay, that is clear. But children, non-green plants cannot make their food. Plants which do not have chlorophyll are called non-green plants. They cannot make their food and usually absorb food from other plants, dead animals or stale food. An example of non-green plants, it is mushroom. So that is clear, children. Now, stages of growth in plants. Stages of growth in plants. It is clearly given in the book, the parts of a plant. The stages of growth in plants. The life cycle of a plant begins with a seed. The life cycle of a plant begins with a seed. So children, this is the life cycle of a plant begins with a seed. Then next, the seed, when it gets water and sunlight, then what happens? It develops into a seedling. The seed, when it gets water and sunlight, it develops into a seedling. So that is clear, children. Then next what happened? The seedling further develops in all the parts of a plant and grow into a plant. The seedling further develops to all the parts and grow into a plant. So this is the picture, children. Okay. Okay, clear? So that is clear. Now, in another way too, I am going to explain to you the parts of a plant. Okay, children, in another way too, for you to understand, I'm going to explain to you in another way the parts of the plant. Means what are the different parts of a plant. So see this picture, children. Okay, clear? Okay. Now, root. This is the root of a plant, no? Parts of a plant. This is the root. So, root give the plant support and absorb water from other nutrients and from the soil. Root give the plant support and absorb water, right? And other nutrients from the soil. Okay, children. Then what does stem do? Stem carries water. Stem carries water and nutrients to the leaves. Stem carries water to the nutrients to the leaves. And then next, leaves make food for the plants by using sunlight, carbon dioxide and water. Then next, fruit. Fruits comes natural fruits. Grow from flowers. Okay. Then flowers, again, it produce fruits and seeds. Flowers, it comes produces fruits and seeds. So that is clear, children. Okay. Now, the types of plants. Types of plants means this picture. I'm going to explain to you that. Okay. Okay, children. Types of plants. Clear, children? Now, trees. Trees are big plants and strong stem. Trees are big plants and strong stem. Sorry, children. Trees are big, very big and strong plants. The stem of the tree is called the trunk. Trees have thick root, branches, fruits and leaves. Trees are big plants and strong plants. Okay. So, name some examples of the trees, children. Coconut tree, mango tree, banyan tree. That is clear? Now, shrubs. Shrubs are small plants. They are bushy in nature. They have woody stems. So, name some examples of shrub, children. Rose, bougainvillea and jasmine. That is clear, children? Now, next, herbs. Herbs are small plants with soft stem. And children, herbs are used for medicines to cure various illness. So, name some examples of herbs, children. Grass, mint, tulsi. Okay. Or you can say spinach. Okay. So, that is cleared. Now, creepers. Creepers creep along the ground. They are weak stems. They creep along the ground. Name some examples of creepers, children. Watermelon, muskmelon, and pumpkin. That is clear? Now, next, climbers. Climbers are weak stems, but they need some support. So, in your house, climbers, when you put a stick to stand straight. Isn't it, children? Climbers are weak stems. So, they need some support to stand straight. A stick or like walls and stick to stand straight. So, examples of climbers, grapevine, money plant, pepper plant. Okay? That is clear. Now, we are going to learn other types of plants. So, thorny plants, children. Where do you find thorny plants? Thorny plants are found in desert areas. You know, children, cactus. You have seen cactus. Isn't it, children? So, thorny plants are found in desert areas. So, that is clear. Now, aquatic plants. Plants which grow on water are called aquatic plants. Water plants we say. Okay. So, name some examples of water plants, children. Water lily and lotus. So, children, I hope you have understood the topic of this lesson. So watch the video and get through the lesson. I will be back again. Okay, children.